best person you could possibly find to run. Now, you don't necessarily need to find the best Republican Party member. You need to find the best person who could win as a Republican or a Democrat, and you talk him into running as a Republican. Because if we do that, and we run positive campaigns, and we show what we can do as Republicans, we can take over the state House and the state Senate. Now, that's the way to do it. You get good candidates. You cannot win without good candidates.
Said it's time to get government off your back and out of your pockets. And he stood before the world and he said, it's time we cut taxes and cut spending. There's been one man who, by the way, led the Reagan delegation from Texas in 1976. A man who has consistently, without compromise, said, I will not vote for any project, no matter how politically popular, no matter how much justification you can come, unless it's authorized by the Constitution, I will vote no. As a result, Congressman Ron Paul has been given the nickname Dr. No. Well, I think it's time that we look big government in the face and say, we don't want federal health care. We don't want federal control over your lives. We don't want the federal government funding and controlling every aspect of our being. We believe in the dream of our founding fathers. We believe in liberty. The man that supports liberty is Ron Paul! System. Ron Paul has served 20 years in Congress, but he will receive nothing in his retirement because he says, I'm not here for myself. I'm here not to increase the size of government, nor their obligation. I'm here to cut the size of government. If you think government's too big, then your candidate is Ron Paul. I've been in the Republican Party since the 70s, and I make no apology for that. I was proud to stand beside men like Ronald Reagan to face down their enemy and to stand for what's right. Ronald Reagan campaigned on a platform and built the Republican Party on a belief that we're going to cut the size of government. He said, we're not going to be the world policemen anymore. It's time we quit thinking we have to solve the problems of the world. I believed that message 25 years ago, and I still believe it today. And that's why I'm standing here to endorse Ron Paul for president.